How do we name attributes? GeneXus suggests a nomenclature that makes it easy to understand the attribute's meaning. When a colleague from the development team tells us that he has added the attraction address attribute to the knowledge base, and we're certain that this colleague follows the nomenclature suggested by GeneXus, then we'll know in which transaction he has added it as an attribute for the user to enter a value. It will be an attraction. In addition, we'll know that the attribute will record the address of the tourist attraction as indicated by its semantic category. GeneXus suggests using the following as nomenclature pattern. First, the name of the entity or entity component. It'll be the transaction's name or the transaction's name followed by the level's name if the attribute belongs to a second level. Next comes the attribute's semantic category. If we need to say something else about the semantic category, for example, that it's the date when the customer was entered into the system, a category qualifier is used. In our knowledge base, we had named the city identifier of a country and entered the name of a country's city without adding the country name. Even though those names do not follow the rule, we did it to make it shorter. Since the relationship between countries and cities is so well known, we'll never be confused and think that cities can exist independently of a country, as would be the case if we had a separate city transaction. We'll go back to this later.